In this lesson, we're going to start at the very beginning and provide formal definitions for what is SSL and what is TLS. Here is the internet. The internet is often depicted as this cloud illustration. But inside, the internet is actually just a bunch of different routers that are handing data off to one another. On either side of the internet is you and who you're speaking to. All of these routers are owned by different ISPs, which stands for Internet Service Provider. And these ISPs are in charge of maintaining these routers, which are going to hand data off to one another. So when you are trying to speak to something on the other side of the internet, you are putting data on the wire, which is then going to be handed off from router to router owned by different ISPs all the way across the internet before it arrives to the other side. The point that I'm trying to make is as soon as you put data on the wire, you no longer have control over what happens to that data. That data is literally in the hands of all these different ISPs as it's passing across the internet. Now, most commonly on the internet, the type of data that is transferred is websites, meaning this server could be the web server in charge of hosting the site, site.com. But what exactly is a website? Well, a website is something written in HTML, which stands for Hypertext Markup Language, and transferred in HTTP, which stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So for example, this right here is an example of HTML. You'll see an HTML page is simply text with different tags and different content that is meant to be displayed by a web browser. And in order for this client to receive a copy of this HTML page, it's going to have to send an HTTP request, which will look something like this. It's asking for the page index.html from the host site.com. This will prompt the web server to respond with a copy of that HTML page. That HTML page will then be handed from router to router across the internet, where it'll arrive on the client, and the client's web browser will turn that into something that's a little bit more visually appealing. So that is the definition of a website and an example of HTML and HTTP. An important thing to understand is that at no point in this process did any sort of encryption happen. This was the HTML page, and this text is literally what was sent across the internet to the other side. It might not look like there's anything too dangerous about anyone in the middle seeing the contents of this particular HTTP transfer, but websites are not always simply displaying information. Sometimes they are asking for information, like a username or a password or a bank account number or a credit card number. If the user fills in all these fields, that'll be sent as is across the internet to the other side, and anyone in the path will have access to what was sent. This is why most browsers will display an error if you start filling in these text boxes that are meant to be transferred in HTTP. And this is actually the problem that SSL and TLS are trying to solve. What SSL and TLS do is they build a secure, protected tunnel across the internet. And now, with this SSL tunnel, the client and the server can share information safely across the internet. What you are looking at here is what's known as HTTPS. HTTPS is an HTML web page transferred using the HTTP protocol secured by an SSL tunnel. But websites are not the only thing that SSL and TLS can protect. They can also protect any other data transfer. This is known as an SSL VPN. The most common use case for an SSL VPN is for a client to connect to some sort of corporate network. The client can build an SSL VPN across the internet to the corporate firewall, and now any corporate resources that the client needs to access, it can access securely through this SSL tunnel. For instance, corporate email or corporate databases or files. The other common example of an SSL VPN is connecting to a public VPN provider, something like ExpressVPN or NordVPN or CyberGhost or a bunch of others. These providers allow a client to build an SSL tunnel to their network, and now any internet-facing traffic that is sent by this client will go through this tunnel into the VPN provider's network and then out to the actual internet. What this does is it hides the IP address of the client and potentially makes the client appear like they're coming from a different location than they really are in. So that is the definition of SSL and TLS. But there's still something we haven't answered. Why do we have two different names for the same function? Well, let's talk about it. SSL stands for Secure Sockets Layer, and TLS stands for Transport Layer Security. SSL is the protocol Netscape created way back in 1994 in order to bring security to the internet. Then, in 1999, the IETF took over maintenance of the SSL protocol. IETF stands for Internet Engineering Task Force, and they are responsible for maintaining many of the public internet protocols, and when they took over the SSL protocol, they renamed the protocol as TLS. That is why there are two different terms. One of them is the protocol that Netscape created and maintained, and the other one is the protocol maintained by the IETF. So you can consider both of these terms as referring to the same protocol, or more accurately, as different versions of the same protocol. Today, the world mostly uses the newer version of the protocol, TLS, but the older term still persists, and people still refer to this as SSL. So typically, these two terms are used interchangeably. But we are actually getting ahead of ourselves. There's actually a few different versions of SSL and a few different versions of a TLS, and we're going to be looking at each of those in a later lesson in this module. So with the answer to what is the difference between SSL and TLS out of the way, we actually bring this lesson to a close. The main takeaways for this lesson is having a clear definition of what SSL and TLS are, in that they create a secure, protected tunnel across the internet, and understanding the three main use cases of SSL and TLS. The first being using HTTPS to securely transfer websites, and the other two being using an SSL VPN to securely connect to a corporate network or to connect to a public VPN provider to hide your identity. In the next lesson, we're going to be looking at what SSL and TLS are doing to actually protect your data. That'll give us a proper definition for what it means to have secure data transfer. But that's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed this video. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.
Did you enjoy this lesson? Do you want to understand the rest of the SSL and TLS ecosystem? If so, you'll want to check out my new course, Practical TLS. It's a comprehensive deep dive into the world of SSL and TLS designed to make you an SSL expert regardless of where you are now. This course is all you need to help you become the next SSL expert on your team or to help you nail those job interview questions. To learn more, check out pracnet.net/TLS or click the link in the description. Otherwise, thank you for watching and we'll see you in the next video.